Hello dear students, so last class this is what we had done, pronouns and the different types of pronouns. In this video we will see the remaining topics, articles, conjunctions, prepositions and interjections. So as we already said, we will start with examples. So the first example, if you look at over here, after the long day the cup of tea tasted particularly good, and the highlighted word over here is the. The would be called as a definite article. Why do we call it as definite? Because it is specifying something which is definite. The helps us to understand that we are talking about that one thing, one person, one object which we particularly want to mention. So it is used before a noun to make it particular. That is how we can make anything special or particular when we use the. So the doctor, the apple, the school. So when we say the, that noun which we are referring to becomes a particular noun. It is used with superlatives. Superlatives, that means the best one or the last one or the among the different in comparison, that would be the only one that is good, better, best. That is how we talk about superlatives. So the long day, that means that is the only one day that we are talking of. Or the cup of tea, so that is that special cup of tea that we are talking about. With it can be used with common nouns and when nouns represent the whole class, that particular class, if you look at it literally. So that is the. Then looking at these two statements, please give me a bottle of water. My mother is an honest woman. Now over here, if you see, can you see the difference between the two? Here we are talking of something in a group, and still in that group, that one thing that is special. Whereas over here, it is very much singular. It is only about one, only about singular. So this could be called as indefinite article. A and an, that means you are not pointing out at someone one special amongst the all, but it is in generally, indefinitely, that one. Okay, so it can be used before countables in the singular number. Look at this, please give me a bottle of water. So this is a water is a singular kind of thing that we are talking of. Second one, my mother is an honest woman. Again, woman is a singular noun. Okay. A is used before a countable number beginning with a consonant sound. All of us know what are vowels and what are consonants. So anything, any word which starts with alphabet other than A, E, I, O, U would be called as consonant. And any alphabet, any word which starts with the alphabet A, E, I, O, U would be the word starting with a vowel. Sometimes the sound of a vowel also makes it a vowel word. So first one, if you see, give me a bottle of water. Over here clearly bottle is a word with a consonant sound. Whereas over here, my mother is an honest woman. Over here, honest in spelling, it may start with an H, but in pronunciation, H becomes silent and it starts with a vowel sound. So it is about the sound, and as you feel the sound, your article changes. So it becomes an. Okay. An is used before a countable number beginning with a vowel sound. And these are the, a, and an are the articles. Now, what are articles actually? Articles are demonstrative adjectives. We know what is the function of an adjective. It is qualifying a noun or a pronoun. That is what adjectives do. For example, look at this. It is the long day. How was the day? Long day. The cup of tea tasted particularly good. How did the tea taste? Good. So this the or a or an, these are articles which are actually demonstrative adjectives, and this point out people or things that are used before the noun. Okay. Let us look at some other statements. These are the three statements, and there is a highlighted word in every statement. I work quickly and carefully. The man is poor but is honest. 2 and 2 make 4. Now look at it very carefully. What do you see? If you look at it, you will see that quickly, carefully, these two words are joined by this word and. Similarly, these two phrase or clause are joined by this word but. So the man is poor, it's a clause. Poor and honest are joined by but. Over here, 2 and 2 make 4. This itself is one clause, but in this we find that these two words are joined by and. Such kind of words which are joining two words, two adjectives, two words, nouns, would be called as conjunctions. So what are conjunctions? Conjunctions are the words that link other words, phrases or clauses together. So if you look in the first statement, this is a clause, I work quickly, but this is a word. So clause and word is joined together by and. Here if we look at it, the man is poor is a clause, is honest is a phrase, and it is joined by but. Now over here we have one clause only, but we have two words that have to be joined, and therefore 2 and 2 make 4. What else about conjunctions? They will allow you to form complex, elegant sentences and avoid the confusion of multiple short sentences. So if I had to put it into multiple, look how weird it would look. I work quickly, full stop. I work carefully, full stop. Okay. The man is poor, full stop. The man is honest, full stop. So how many sentences do we make which makes no sense? Even if 10 times we write the same thing, it is about that one man which can get compiled in one statement. And therefore conjunctions help us to make the sentences more elegant, more crisp, more proper, and of course it makes it also complex, because then we have clauses and phrases put together, then we have two different sentences put together and made into one. Okay, we have to make sure that the phrases joined by conjunctions share the same structure. So over here if you look at it, quickly and carefully, both are adverbs. Okay, poor and honest, both are adjectives. 2 and 2, both are nouns, numeral nouns. Okay, so now let us look at the various types of conjunctions that we find in languages. One is coordinating conjunction, then we have correlative conjunctions, and then we have subordinating conjunctions. These are the basic three types of conjunctions that we find in English language. Now, what would be a coordinating conjunction? See, the word itself is defining how it would be and what it would be, but still we will look at the types of words that are used as conjunctions. So I would like pizza or salad for lunch. We need a place to concentrate, so we packed up our things and went to the library. Jessie didn't have much money, but she got by. Now over here, what are the words highlighted? Or, for, so, and, but. These are the words which have a which are put into some kind of we call it as mnemonics, which is fan boys. So F stands for, A stands for and, N stands for nor, B stands for but, O for or, Y for yet, and S for so. Over here some of it we have used, not all the words from this mnemonic, but this is how we remember the conjunctions also. Okay, so for, or, so, and, but, yet. These are all nor. These are all the words which help us to join the phrases or the words together. Pizza or a salad for lunch. So joining one clause or one, two, three phrases together, or one clause, one phrase and one word together. We need a place to concentrate, so we packed up our things. So this is also joining two clauses together. And then it carries on. So it will allow you to join words, phrases and clauses of equal grammatical rank in a sentence. What is equal grammatical rank? Pizza, salad, lunch. These are the three which would come under noun. We need a place to concentrate is one clause. We packed up our things is second clause. Went to the library would be third. And therefore, three clauses joined together. Jessie didn't have money, but she got by. So again, two clauses are put together and it becomes a complex statement. This is coordinating conjunction. So it should coordinate. It should be equal in the grammatical rank. Next one, when we look at it, correlative conjunction. Correlative, something which is relating equally. So not only am I finished studying for English, but also finished writing my history essay. So if I am using this term not only, then automatically but also relates to it and therefore correlative. We have such other words also. When we use either, we use or. Either you buy yellow dress or you buy white dress. Neither nor. Neither do I want Gucci nor do I want Baguette. And not only but also. This is the statement over here. Not only am I finished doing this but also I finished the other thing. Okay, so these are the pairs of conjunctions that work together. One is incomplete without the other pair. If I am using either, obviously I have to understand that I will use or. Either you go or they can go. So they correlate with each other and therefore they are called as correlative conjunctions. Then we have subordinating conjunctions. So one will be a subordinate of other. Now let us see what becomes the subordinate of other. I can stay out until the clock strikes 12. This word until. So till when can I stay out? This is a complete statement. The clock strikes 12 is a subordinating statement or a subordinating clause. And therefore until will join these two statements. One is a clause and one is a phrase. Okay. Before he leaves, make sure his room is clean. Now this is when we are starting with. So not necessarily always a conjunction would be in the middle of the statement. But it does join. Even if it doesn't position itself in the middle of the statement, it does join a clause and a phrase or a word or two words. So here you see it's a different case. Before comes, you know, at the start of the statement, which is a conjunction. But we see that if before was not used, then this phrase and this clause, make sure his room is clean, is a complete statement and therefore it's a main clause. Whereas this is an incomplete statement and therefore it is a subordinate clause. He leaves. So to make it look as if it is joining this main clause, before is used. Okay, let us look at another statement. I drank a glass of water because I was thirsty. Now these are two statements and both can be complete statement. But when we add it because, the statements make some sense. And therefore this would become a subordinating statement. So because, since, as, although, through, though, while and whereas, until, after, before. These are called as subordinating conjunctions because they join the main clause with the subordinate clause. So over here the repetition, if you can see, joining independent and dependent clause, that is main and subordinate clause, and can signal variety of relationships between the clause. So because of something, since something happened, therefore this. So it could be cause effect, it could be a result, it could be problem solution, etc. Okay, so this was about conjunctions. Let us go beyond and see the next type of part of speech, that is prepositions. This you should read to understand what it is. Above the ground, across the grass, before a bench, in the dirt, near a friend, next to a gate, on the floor, soaring through the air. Now, this is a small poetry if you see, and this poem is helping us to also see the position of these nouns. Okay, so above the ground, across the grass, before a bench. Can you see that? In, near, next, on, through. Now, so we can say that prepositions are the words, these short words, which are used to link the nouns, various nouns. Here, because it is in poetic form, we are not looking at the linking of the two nouns, but we definitely know that there is one noun to be understood which is linking with the other noun which is mentioned in the poem. So pronouns or phrases to other words within a sentence. Also, one more thing to note is that preposition is a word which itself defines its own property. So something which is positioned before, preposition. And if you see, prepositions are always positioned before the noun. Can you see in all the statements? Yes. Right? Okay. So they act to connect people. They can connect objects. They can connect time, location of a sentence. So they are big connectors in English language. And prepositions connect various nouns, pronouns, phrases, people, objects, times, and locations. They are normally placed directly in front of nouns, and therefore the word preposition. So they are positioned before the noun and immediately before the noun. This we should always remember. In some cases, you will find that preposition is in front of a gerund verb. Gerund verb is the verb that starts with ing, the verb that has ing in it. So having, thinking. You will see that, you know, many a times that these are found in front of the gerund verbs, and then also it could be called as a preposition. Now we have variety of prepositions, preposition of time, preposition of place, that is position and status. Okay. Now this is a list of prepositions of time you can see. In English, when we are using these words, this also shows us the position of time. So on, in, at, since, for, ago, before, to, past, to or till, and by. See the usage? On and in can be used for the days, for the weeks, for the month, season, year, time of the day, and after a certain period. Anything that is defining time for us. On and in can be used. So on Monday, in August, we have to remember when do we use on and when do we use in. Okay. On is when we are specifically looking at one special day probably or one special time. And in would be a special but a group of, you know, days or weeks that are put together. So in August, in month, it is categorically put as in. So August is a category of month. Okay. Winter is a category of seasons. 2006 would be the category of year, whereas Monday is one day. It's a category in the week. It's a name of a day, but it is one day. Okay. Then at can be used for night, for weekend, or at a certain point of time. So at night or at the weekend. When we want to talk about night or weekend or something like this, then it is at. Since is always in the past, from past till now, we can say. So from a certain point of time. For also same, for a certain period of time. So since 1980, When we are using for a very long time, then we can use since. When we use for something which is more nearer, so for 2 years. But if we say since 2 years is also not wrong, but it is not a very big time, 2 years that we're talking of. Whereas 1980, when we talk something in a bigger distance, in a bigger time period, then it could be since. Ago is also something used in for the past time, so 2 years ago. If you want to say for 2 years, then it is, that means it is continuing till the present. But if you want to talk about something which happened in the past and ended in the past, it is not continuing in the present, then it would be 2 years ago. Before, earlier than a certain point of time. So before 2004, there is a time fixed, and before that I'm talking of. Okay, then two, if we are telling the time to somebody else, then we say 10 to 6. Okay. Similarly, past also, if we are telling the time, then we can say 10 past 6. Now see the difference. When I am saying 10 to 6, that means there is time remaining. And when I am saying 10 past 6, that means the time is over. Okay, so there is a difference. Both are for telling the time, to and past. But it depends on how we want to portray that time. So I could have said over here, if I have to use past for this particular time, then I would say it is past 45 minutes to 5. So 5:50. But to be exact, 10 to 6. So 10 minutes is remaining for 6. Then to or till, again, somewhere it comes to about the time. But till is basically over here more important, marking the beginning and the end of a period of time. So from Monday till Friday, we have classes. But we can also make it shorter version and say from Monday to Friday, we have classes. Both are correct. Okay. Then by, in the sense of at least at the latest up to a certain time. So I will be back by 6 o'clock. This is the latest I should be back by, or by 11 o'clock I had read 5 pages. So the latest time till when the event went on, or when I would be doing or finishing my work, there we can use this preposition by. Next is preposition of place, position and direction or status. Again, if you look at it in English, in. Now you saw in is also used for time. It is also used for place. At, on, by, next to, under, below, over, above, across, through, to, into, towards, onto, from. There are some which are repetition of the preposition of time, and therefore we can use one for the other. Only the nouns will change. So in, if I'm saying, then the usage would be room, building, street, town, country. So in the kitchen, in India. Okay. When I say at, then for events, place where you are, I am at the door. Which place I am, what is my position, where I am placed or where the event is placed. On is where things are attached to. So the picture is on the wall. And it is used for a place for certain side. Then by or next to, it is left or right of somebody or something. So Jane is standing beside the car, next to the car, by the car. We can also use the term standing right next to the car or left side next to the car. Okay. Then under, which is on the ground, and lower. Therefore, the bag is under the table. That is inside, in beneath something or beneath somebody. Okay, so it is either on the ground or it is lower than something. Below also for the same purpose. The fish are below the surface. Then covered, overcoming an obstacle. That is when over is used. So put a jacket over your shirt or walk over the bridge. That means you are overcoming an obstacle, or you are covering something, you are covering a distance, you are covering your body, you are covering. So it is position and direction both. In terms of both, it can be used. then above. Higher than something else. How below is lower than something else? Similarly, above is higher than something else. So a path above the lake. Then across, getting to the other side. This is simple. Walk across the bridge. Walk across the road. So getting to the other side. Next is something with limits on top, bottom or sides. Through. So you are showing your limitation that I can go through this much only. Drive through the tunnel. Whether it is, you know, on the top, it is on the bottom side that you are talking that you can cross through, or it is on the sides. But it shows the limits. Then movement to a person or a place. Two can be used for this also. Two can be also used for the preposition of time. Remember, but how it is, it changes. Over here, if you see, it is talking about go to London, go to bed. So this is about a person or a place that to is used. And then we say it is preposition of place. Then enter a room or a building, into. So in and into again can be replacements for each other. Then movement in the direction of something is towards. Go towards the house, go towards the school, go towards east, go towards west. So position or direction is found. Then on to, movement to the top of something, jump onto the table. There is one more which is talking above. So onto and above, somewhere sometimes we use one for the other. Then from, in the sense of where from. So a flower from the garden. From where did one noun come and relate to the other? So objects or nouns, for if we want to show their position, then from. Okay, now some important prepositions that we should keep in mind, which are again initially when we saw in pronouns also, it and there were like exceptions. Similarly here we have some. So from, of, by. If you see, these are having double usage. So who gave it? A present from Jane. Of, it will talk about what does it belong to or what does it show. So off the page. By means who made it? A book by Mark Twain. On, it could also be walking or riding on. So on foot, on public transport, on the, get on the bus. In would be entering. On and in, the difference is one, the vehicle or something that you're using to. And in is you are sitting in that and riding. Then leaving a public transport vehicle off, get off the train. So you are leaving it and therefore you're using OFF off. Out of also could be the same thing. Get out of the taxi, get out of the, generally for train, we would say boarding the train and getting off the train. Okay. Then by. Rise or fall of something traveling other than walking or horse riding. So prices have risen by 10%. Or we say we are traveling by car, by bus. When we are talking about the fall and rise of something, that also has the preposition of by. Especially in share markets you will see, or especially when we are talking about inflated rates of something, we will say, or marks, or these are about the numbers that we're talking of in percentage, something has gone higher or lower, then we can say use the preposition by. Then at is also used for age, and age somewhere relates to time also. So she learned Russian at 45. Okay, about is for the topics, or it also has meaning what about. So we were talking about you. You is the topic over here. Or we were talking what about you. Okay. Next, look at this statement. Lima is the capital of Peru. Ouch, that hurts. Now these are interjections because you can see somewhere we understand the emotion. So interjections or common interjections used generally anytime are, ah, my God, air, hey, ouch, Then, hey, don't be so lazy. Well, let's think about it. Again, Interjections in the context of mild emotion. Awesome, alas, phew. Now, if you look at it, these are interjections. Now, what is an interjection? You can see this. These are all the emojis that we use, or we can also call as emoticons, or in general terms, we call it as emotions. So, interjections relate to our emotions. They are expressing emotion or some sudden feeling that we have, and when we are using in written form, it is the words that we use which becomes interjections. For example, we saw an am are also known as hesitation device. So the emotion expressed through this term would be hesitation, because you can't show these faces while you write statement in the language, especially formal language. And we can have some hesitation devices to be used. Okay. It has no grammatical function to the rest of the sentence. That means how prepositions, conjunctions, or other parts of speech, they are grammatically involved in a statement. They have some kind of function in the statement. Interjections do not have a grammatical function other than only showing emotion, which is not grammatical in nature. So it doesn't make any sense unless you don't want to express that emotion. They are generally set off from the rest of the sentence by an exclamation point or by a comma. Any of these two could be used, but it should be just next to the word. It cannot be at the end of the word. The part of speech will change and become a type of sentence then. Therefore, it has to always be next to the word that is expressing the emotion. Okay. Now, what are interjections? We also need to remember, which is shown in interjection, because the emotion is very strong over here. You should remember. Then when you use interjections frequently, when you speak, okay? But we have to use them sparingly when we are writing, because too much of emotions in written expression makes it difficult for a person to understand the formal message behind that written expression. Overuse of interjections will also spoil the effectiveness, as I told you. So they can be used mainly when we want to write something in a dialogue form and not in a formal statement or article. If we are writing, you cannot keep using interjections. Yes, some point of interjections are allowed to some extent, but that is only at that section, in that section where you want to show an emotion very strong. Thank you for this session. We will meet in the next video.